According to the Yumbe District Forest Officer, they received 15 million shillings from the unconditional grants of the district, which they used to grow the species. He added that the main aim of giving all the seedlings to farmers is to ensure the degraded environment in the district is restored.
It is the mandate of the government, NFA, also NFA's mandate, that every sector where they are working, they are supposed to support the community in the community tree planting program. So we get seedlings from them.
Adara Alia, the Secretary for Production and Natural Resources in Yumbe, lauded the Forest Department for the initiative. The seasons have now changed. We were having two seasons where farmers would grow their crops, but now it's only one season which has unpredictable rains. I think it's time that we wake up and start to grow trees so that the situation can change. If you reach home with the seedlings, please make sure you pour in a lot of water and guard it to grow. Yumbe Resident District Commissioner John Bosco Tumwesije urged farmers to grow as many trees as they can to combat climate change.
Is available, very fertile, but unutilized. I am happy this time. These bush areas surrounding Yumbe will be filled with trees.
Ashraf Anule, a farmer, expressed gratitude over the opportunity to get the seedlings.
My target mostly is I wanted fruit trees. You know, Yumbe mostly for fruits, we normally buy fruit from Maracha, from other places, you know, Dramachako and so on. But now, I personally, I felt that I need to plant more fruits.
Meanwhile, civil society organizations on environmental conservation, joined by licensed tree growers from across the country, have asked the government to revisit the recent presidential directive on charcoal and timber export. During a stakeholder meeting held today in Kampala, tree growers revealed that the directive is still unclear on their position as licensed timber sellers.
They say there is a directive, there is an order, but nobody really says what it is. They even say it's not a ban. But the thing is that when you go to access the market, the other arms of government like customs do not recognize the licenses.
Police has come out to enforce a ban, and this has led to quite a number of implications. You cannot easily move your timber now, you cannot produce timber, you cannot export timber, and even charcoal, by the way, the charcoal business is becoming affected.
Ivan Tomohimbise, the WWF country director, explains that much as the directive is a timely response to the increase in deforestation and environmental degradation in the country, it needs to, however, protect those involved in commercial tree growing who contribute to the biggest percentage of forest cover.
The government of Uganda, through NFA and other actors, have not been able to make investments in the increasing tree cover. Most of the forest, the increase in forest cover currently, as we speak now, over the last 5-7 years, the increase has been made by private forest planters.
Some members have also agreed that we shall formally submit our petition to the responsible body, which is the Minister of Water and Environment, particularly the Minister responsible for forestry, one expressing the implication of this ban on the tree farmers, but also its implication on the economy and the livelihoods.
In the May 24 Executive Order No. 3, President Museveni guided that only factories processing timber with Uganda for the production of plywood, furniture, and other value-added products should be allowed to operate, but with sustainable tree planting and harvesting plans. Once enacted, the directive will affect over 2,000 commercial tree growers, timber dealers, lumberers, and those engaged in the timber value chain. Story compiled by Adam Gule and Rachel Natuwala for the news.